So in this video, I take Alex, a 19-year-old foundation license holder, he's only just passed his test 2 days ago, and I throw him in at the deep end on 40 metres. Stick around to see how it went.
It's Golf 5, Sierra Tango, uniform, listening for any calls.
I think you're on a hill somewhere. I wonder if the hill has a name.
This is Golf 5, Sierra Tango, uniform, portable, listening. 5-9 into the south coast of the UK, over.
So this week, Alex, M7PKY, he's 19 years old, he lives just down the road from me. I've only known him a few weeks. We met through a Discord server, we're both computer programmers, so we work in the same industry. We've actually been working together on some Discord bots and various other bits and bobs on open source projects that we're both involved in. So Alex, he's a top bloke, very, very clever, and I'm super happy that he's now in the hobby and able to transmit on the amateur bands. So well done, Alex. Top job. So Alex came to meet me down at my local DXing spot at Paul Key this week. He was buying a handheld radio off of me, so he popped down on his bike to say hello. It was actually a nice sunny day. I was on HF testing out a new antenna that M7LWT had sent me. It's the Sky Ranger. It's an adjustable, slidable coil, and I was testing that out when Alex came to visit. When Alex arrived, I was doing some testing. I got it nicely tuned up, 1-to-1 SWR. It was absolutely cracking out. Alex rocks up on his bike to pick up the handheld. After a little conversation, I was scanning up and down 40 metres and noticed MM0JVB. That's Jimmy up in Scotland. So I called into Jimmy, said hello. We've had a few contacts before. And I essentially said to Jimmy, would you mind if I throw the mic over to M7PKY? He's never made a HF contact before, so this will be his first contact. Jimmy obviously obliged, so I handed the mic over, turned the power down accordingly. Alex then went on to make his first contact on HF, and what a top job he did of it too. Now I just want to give a quick shout out to Jimmy, absolutely fantastic bloke. He really did a superb job with Alex. Alex was obviously a little bit nervous, didn't quite know what the protocol and what to say and everything else, but he picked it up very quickly. He has actually been transmitting on the DMR mode, so he's not completely green, but it's his first time actually on HF. So I just want to give a shout out to Jimmy because he's actually arranged to send Alex a QSL card for his first HF contact. Now, how cool is that? I mean, how many people can say they've actually got a QSL card to log their first ever contact on HF? Not many, unless you probably started back in the old days. And I don't mean that in a derogatory sense. I just mean that in QSL cards used to be the norm many moons ago. So yeah, in the modern day, they're a rarity. I've actually got one here from the Falkland Islands. It's the only one I've ever received. Victor Papa 8 Alpha Delta Radio sent me that a few weeks ago when we made contact on 20 meters at about 9-10 o'clock. Was it in the morning or the afternoon? I can't actually remember, but it was a superb contact, and thanks for that, Bobby. I shall treasure that forever, as will Alex, his first ever QSL card on 40 meters with Jimmy, MM0JVB. So well done, Alex, and I've got a few little clips here, so let's have a little bit of a listen. So there we go. Unfortunately, I realised as I was editing the video, I don't actually have any footage of Alex talking, which is a bit annoying, but hey ho. We got a bit of a record there of his first contact on HF with Jimmy. So thanks, Jimmy, once again. Top bloke. Now, before I go, I just want to show you a little clip from Keith from Bulgaria. I spoke to him a few weeks back on 15 metres. He sent me a little video to say hello and a little recording of the contact.
Hi, Stu. Greetings from Bulgaria. You've started to fade a little bit now. gone right down. Conditions are changing, but you're absolutely booming at first. Before I shouted to you, I was messing about and was listening. Didn't really get a chance to call you straight away, but as soon as I did, you were banging through, mate. 5.9, 5.9, super, just outside Varna on the Black Sea coast. A little village called Vetrino. Victor Echo Tango Romeo India November Oscar, Vetrino. Grid is Kilo November 33 Romeo Hotel, KN33R8. So have a look, mate. And as you say, you're still there, but you're fading. You've stopped again. Anyway, you take care, mate. Nice talking to you. Nice getting you in that logbook. Speak very soon. You take care, buddy. Bye bye for now.
So we're on 20 watts on both settings, and happy days. I mean, you're coming in super strong. I mean, Russia's been coming in strong. I've got a few contacts from Russia on the van, and been hearing a few other sort of America sort of. Southern American sort of long distance stations as well coming in. So, certainly lively on the back. There's a process going on 40 and 80 and all the usual bands. So, we'll have sort of steered away from them for the day. Since Uno 2 Uniform, Delta 5 Silver Tango Uniform Mobile.
Okay, Stuart. Well, I've just took a little bit of video, and what I'll do. I was just having a look, see if you've got an email page, but I can't see it. So
there we go. What a couple of good stories from the last few weeks of my world of amateur radio. If you're looking to expand your circle and meet new people every single day of the week, then amateur radio really is a fantastic hobby. I know it has a really bad image from the outside, and the people within the community don't really seem to help themselves, to be honest with you. I'm not sure I'm doing a good job either, but I'm trying to get across the message that it's not all about the technical nerdy side of things, although some people do tend to focus 100% on that. Whatever, if that floats your boat, crack on. But there's also a fantastic community there as well of just meeting people, talking to people, and expanding your circle, just meeting people from all over the world. So there we go, amateur radio, get your call sign today. Well, maybe not today, but as Alex has proven, you can get it quite quickly. He got his within a month. Well, within 2 months of starting to listen to amateur radio bands, Alex has got his license. So there we go, it can be done. You don't have to be a rocket scientist to get your amateur radio license, certainly not at the foundation level. So thanks for watching, we'll see you in the next video.
Golf 5, Sierra Tango, uniform, listening for any calls.
I think you're on a hill somewhere. I wonder if the hill has a name.
This is Golf 5, Sierra Tango, uniform, portable, listening. 5.9 into the south coast of the UK, over.
Roger, Stuart, you're on call 5.9 up here into Manchester.